Between 1999 and 2002, Today's Guest scored 8 top 10 singles, whilst Take On Me and Same Old Brand New You went straight to the top of the UK singles chart. Now, it's a pretty well-kept secret that A1 are actually back. We welcome them right now to talk about their reunion. Please welcome Ben, Christian and Mark. It's A1.
Yes.
Woo! That deserves a whoop, guys.
It does. There's a whoop from all the people behind the cameras.
Yes.
Great.
I feel like I've stepped back in time right now. I'm in boy band heaven. How are you all?
Very good.
Yeah?
Very good. We're in chart show heaven. So that's good.
That's what we like to hear. Now, guys, you've been together for 12 years, which is very impressive. But in 2002, you decided to call it a day. So why did you decide to go your separate ways?
Well,
I've already spoken. It's your turn.
Yeah, it's my turn, I guess. Yeah. It was one of those natural things. We were on the road for like 5 years. And even before we started releasing albums, we had been working really hard, 18-hour days, 7 days a week. All the bands did back then. You know, we'd see S Club 7 just lying flat out on the floor wherever we were. Everyone was just sleeping 5 minutes here, 10 minutes there, wherever we could get. So we were tired. We were really tired. And we thought, we'll just have a break. Mm-hmm. And we needed it. And Paul had quit the band a while before. And we thought, well, it's time we took a break now as well. And the break just lasted a little bit longer than we'd planned for.
Okay. And how did the reunion come about?
Well, actually, Christian, who had a very successful solo career back in his home country of Norway, invited us over for just a one-off TV show. And big summer show they have over there. Gets the biggest ratings and everything like that. So he called us up, myself and Ben, would you like to come over and do this? And we thought about, yeah, why not? You know, we didn't have a view to actually bring the band back together and release an album or anything like that. We flew over, did the show. It ended up getting record ratings and just the audience alone, I think like 12,000 people turned up. So it was pretty big. So we thought we'd take it from there. Universal, the label over there, decided to sign us up to an album deal, a new single deal. And so yeah, it all just sort of happened from there. So what was just gonna be like a one-off ended up being a full-blown reunion.
Wow.
So up to this point, it's just been in Scandinavia. So, yeah. But obviously with all the you know, Facebook and Twitter and things like that, we've had UK fans getting absolutely rabid, asking us when we're gonna come back here. So we've left it long enough, so here we are.
Perfect. Now, guys, as you mentioned, Paul did leave the band. Did he not want to join the reunion?
We didn't ask him back, really.
No. Fair enough.
Well, no, he obviously, as Christian said, he left the band before we'd even ended as A1.
Yeah.
So it just didn't feel natural to invite him back.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, at the time he actually left for his reasons. I mean, he wasn't really quite as comfortable in the spotlight as we were and doing what we were doing. So he left for his reasons, so it felt, you know, just natural just to come back as a three.
Perfect. Now, Steps have had a successful comeback, and Take That's comeback has been the most successful so far, I'd say. But comebacks aren't always, they don't always work out. E17 and All Saints sort of tried to relight that fire and it didn't work. So are you worried that reforming may scar the success you had before, or not really?
Well, no matter what happens, no one can change the fact that we, like you said, we had a lot of success,
yeah.
We had a lot of fun back in the days. And we'll always, you know, cherish all those memories, and no matter what happens now, we're just in it to have fun. And we're not in this to, you know, try to make a quick buck or anything. This is something, again, that happened quite gradually. As Mark said, we were doing one TV show that led to another and another and a concert, and we did 55 concerts back in Scandinavia. And then because of basically popular demand, we're back and we're loving it. And we're having such a great time together. And when we started writing songs together again, we realized that in many ways we're stronger when we're together individually than we are when we're alone. So we thought this is great fun, and we're doing it for as long as people want to hear us, or as long as people want to, you know, want us to keep bringing out new songs, we'll do it because we love it.
And would you ever do a documentary like Steps, like a reunion documentary to follow you guys around? I think people want to know what you get up to.
Well, I mean, we do have quite exciting lives. You know, we do some really, really cool things. So I think a camera crew following us around would have a lot of stuff to see.
Yeah.
So it's not a bad idea. I mean, they just went to number one or something, didn't they? So it's obviously
worked.
Yeah,
exactly.
For
the
them.
Album went to number one.
So who knows?
Maybe
you want to follow us around with
yes,
the camera? Is that what you're asking?
Excellent. Follow you around.
Absolutely great. Everywhere.
Between sort of splitting up and reuniting, what have you guys been up to individually? I know you went to Celebrity Big Brother, so what was that like?
That was boring.
Really?
I'll be honest, it was pretty boring. But it was a good experience, and I did a lot of strange things after Big Brother as well, just sort of, I don't know, lots of random stuff. So it was a lot of fun, but I'm pretty pleased to be back doing what I love best.
Okay, cool.
Although I do love living, so that's what I was doing in there, just living on TV. But it's
sitting on a sofa.
Sitting on a sofa, then maybe I'd move hours. To the next sofa, then I'd go to the diary room, you know, that kind of exciting stuff. But no, it's great to be back with the guys.
And Christian, what were you up to?
Like Mark said, I've been pursuing a solo career and released 3 albums in Norway. And also, like the other guys, been producing and writing for other artists and have a studio back home. And just music, really, concerts and Christmas tours. And I made a Christmas album.
Really?
Proud.
Yeah, yeah.
It's great.
Very nice.
So with the Czech National Symphony Orchestra, like a big crooner style album. So I've been touring each Christmas with that. The suit every day for a month. Yeah, so a lot of stuff like that. Just same old, but by myself. But it's really great to be back with the guys and so much more fun now.
And Mark, you were in the studio, weren't you?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, after the band, you know, called it a day for a while, the natural thing for me was to just get back in the studio, and I signed a publishing deal as a writer, and I got to write with so many people, you know, the Bee Gees, Charlotte Church, Michael Bolton, so I've just kind of been getting my head down into the whole thing. But obviously, you kind of, nothing can replace that kind of feeling you get from falling on stage, so I just couldn't wait to get back out there. And
falling on stage?
Yes, falling on stage. Yes,
falling on stage.
Great, I love it. And by the way, just to clear things up, I didn't spend 8 years in the Big Brother house.
I don't know if I did do other things, but
it seemed
fine.
Like that when we were watching.
It's okay, okay, great, thanks. You all know what you did.
Fine, it's great.
Now, you guys released a cover of A-ha's Take On Me back in 2000, and it went on to become your first UK number one single, so well done for that, guys. Now, whose idea, who deserves a pat on the back for giving you that chance to cover A-ha?
Well, we can remember we'd had several consecutive top 5 hits, but we hadn't quite, you know, broken to the number one spot, and that's what every band, you know, certainly at that point, I'm sure today as well, wanted a number one UK number one hit. So we thought, you know, what best way to get that kind of attention than with a cover version? So we all sat down, we had a meeting about it, and we all suggested a lot of cover versions. Some of them, in fact, have been since covered by other bands. So we had a good list of songs, really. But the thing with Take On Me is Norway's most famous band is A-ha.
Yeah.
So Christian, being from Norway, it's a bit kind of like treading on dangerous ground, covering a song like that. But we made sure that we did a good version of it. We updated it and stuff. And but actually, the actual idea, I think, was our manager. He suggested it. And you were a bit kind of dubious about it.
I said, no way. So basically, we said, well, I said, unless, you know, I'll be killed back in Norway if we don't do that song justice. And so we said, if we don't like the version, we won't do it. So, you know, we worked hard in the studio, and then when we got the mix back, I think we sent the mix back 5 times. We're in Australia, so we can't release this. And then finally they got it absolutely spot on, and we thought, well, it's actually quite exciting, and we liked it, so.
Perfect.
Same with the video as well. It was important to come up with something. It was important to come up with something quite, you know, groundbreaking for its time. And in terms of pop music videos of that era, it really was. I mean, certainly UK videos, it had some fantastic effects, groundbreaking effects, inspired by The Matrix. and not the other way round that some fans perhaps thought. So yeah, and it did really well, won lots of awards as a music video, and we had a lot of fun. We spent like 8 hours in a harness hanging on from wires. Actually, that's not
that fun. Did you get loads of bruises?
You know, there are actually people holding you, and they hold ropes. One, there's two guys for each person. So one will pull you up and down, and one will pull you back and forth.
Really?
And we almost got a bruise once because we were hanging out there, flying, doing the thing, and suddenly, we fell to the ground, like stop right up above the ground, and it was those guys. Oh, it's tea time.
We're gonna let you go because we want to go and get some food.
Yeah.